All right, let's get started with understanding the cash flow statement. The first thing that we're going to discuss is the types of cash flows. There are various types, different types of transactions in a business. We need to categorize them into transactions which bring money into the business and transactions which take money out of the business. So let's do a brainstorming on where all do you get the cash from. You get the cash coming into the business primarily when you sell the goods. So through sales, you get cash. However, it is possible that you are selling goods on credit, in which case you're not receiving the cash right now. So that means we are essentially talking about cash sales, sales for which you receive immediate cash. And for sales, for which you recover money later from the customers, you can call them recovery from customers or received from customers at a later point in time, payments from customers. So these are two primary sources of cash in a business. Other than this, you could possibly receive income from any other sources. So let me write any other incomes, and again cash, not the accrued incomes. If you have received the income, received the cash against the income, that is the part of the transaction that we are talking about here. Okay, other than this, you could possibly raise new capital. Shareholders can bring in money. So share capital can bring money into the business. You could also raise loans from banks, loans from other financial institutions. Then debenture is also a kind of loan that you take, not from one institution, but multiple institutions or multiple individuals, debenture. So you could also have, the equity shares or preference shares. So the share capital can be divided into two. There. And in addition to this, you could sell some assets during the year because its life has ended, or the utility is, there is no more any utility for those assets in the business. So let's say sale of fixed assets of the business here. In addition to this, you could, I think primarily these are the cash flows. Then what I was thinking of was other incomes, which can be from different sources. You could earn interest on the deposits from bank, or you could have dividend which you earn on the investment in shares, etc. Okay, so these are the categories of cash inflows. There may be one or two more here and there, but largely this covers how cash comes into the business. Now, how does cash go out of the business? Well, all the things which are opposite of these. When we have cash sales here, we can write the opposite of this, which is purchases. When you purchase and you pay in cash, that is what we're talking about. So cash purchases, you can have payment to vendors, which is later after the purchase has been done, payment to creditors. You can have all the rest of expenses, and expenses can be operating, they can be non-operating, they can be direct, indirect, all the expenses which are paid in cash. We're not talking about the accrued expenses, meaning the expenses have become due but you've not paid them. We are only talking about expenses for which you pay in cash. Alright, so these are the outflows. In addition to this, we may pay dividend to the shareholders. So any dividend paid, we can also pay interest on the loans. So let me write finance cost, financial expenses. This includes all the interest. Then you have loans. You could pay the loans, repayment of loans or debentures. Sale of fixed asset, the opposite of that is purchase. purchase of fixed assets or any other investment that you make. When you make the investment, at that time cash goes out. Do not, you know, get confused by saying, hey, I'm purchasing an asset, that's a good thing for business. Good things separate. We're talking about what happens to cash. You purchase an asset, but in exchange, cash is going out of the business. All right, so these are the items of cash outflow, the transactions which affect cash immediately, not later on. Now, are there any transactions which do not affect cash, but we still record them in the business? Yes, there are. There are accrued expenses, outstanding expenses. There are accrued incomes, incomes earned, not received incomes. There are transactions like depreciation. In depreciation, we do not pay any vendor any amount of money. We are just writing down, we are just writing off, we are just reducing the value, the book value of a given asset, and that's it. We're not paying anybody. So depreciation does not affect the cash balance of the business. And if you remember, the journal entry for depreciation is depreciation account debit to the asset account, which means cash account is not involved at all. Depreciation and amortization, as discussed earlier various times, amortization is depreciation on intangible assets. So both are, you know, similar in nature, except that they apply on different natures of fixed assets, different types of fixed assets. Okay, other than this, there are there can be you know, creation of reserves. Let me write reserves. Reserves can be general or can be specifics. So creation of reserves basically means you make some profit during the year, and then within the business, out of the profit, you create a separate head and say it's a reserve. I'm going to use this money for some purpose, you know, whenever that purpose arrives, or for various different purposes, whenever those purposes arise. So this money is not being given to anybody right now. So any creation of reserve does not affect the cash in the business. Also, there is, you know, provision that you create in the business. Provision, again, is kind of a specific reserve that you create to meet your liabilities, possible liabilities in the short run. So provisions could be on payment of tax, on payment of dividend, for bad debts. So the purpose is basically to have the money when it is required. So just put aside some money, and you call it a provision, because typically any reserve created for short term, for more specific purpose, we call it a provision. So we've seen transactions which involve cash and which do not involve cash. So clearly there is, you know, there are a number of transactions in each of these three categories. And in the cash flow statement, we are going to use the data from the final accounts, from the balance sheet and income statement. And then we're going to say, let's forget about the profit made, net profit during the year, because that is not equal to the cash that you make. And I will you know, emphasize that, clarify that point going forward in the course as well. But the idea is to segregate the non-cash transactions from the cash transactions, and say, if we leave out the non-cash, then you know, what are the other transactions which affected the cash and how. So let's move forward. The next thing to do is, after having understood the inflows and the cash transactions which bring in the money and take out the money, we will now divide the inflows and outflows into three subcategories. And those three categories are operating, investing, and financing. So what we are saying is the cash comes into the business due to operating activities of the business. So there can be cash inflows due to operating activities. However, there can also be cash outflows. So there can be cash outflows due to operating activities. Can you tell me what is the amount that came into the business or the net amount after the operating activities? if you take into consideration only the primary activities of the business, the main activities of the business, did we make cash or did we lose cash, right? So the net result of this is going to be that you either have cash inflow or outflow, one of the two. Can you tell me the net outcome of the operating activities of the business? Likewise, can you tell me the net result, cash inflow, cash outflow? The net result, which means cash flow, which could either be inflow or outflow. So cash flow resulting from investing activities of the business, and likewise cash flows resulting from the financing activities of the business. And this categorization has been provided in the accounting standards which are followed. So this is a required statement as well, and we have, you know, there is a format which we have to template, which we have to follow, and I'll introduce you to that as well. So to again summarize, till now we are saying that we have to categorize the transactions into cash and non-cash transactions, and then within the cash transactions we will sub-categorize the transactions into cash flows from operating, investing and financing activities. Okay, let me talk a little bit more about each of these three activities. What are operating activities of the business? Operating activities of the business are purchase and sales, all the operating expenses, all the other operating expenses, which typically include cost of goods sold and rest of operating expenses, as we have discussed earlier. In terms of inflows, you have sales, you have cash sales, and you can also recover from the customers. So receivables received, not the receivables. Actually, when the customer makes the payment, that's what we're talking about here, because cash is of importance here. So for operating activities, we are looking at cash flows as a result of only these activities. Whatever else can be fitted into the definition of operating activities of the business. Again, we have discussed the concept of operating expenses and operating incomes. Now we are saying, what is the result of the operating incomes and expenses? Tell me the operating profit. But not only operating profit, we are saying operating cash profit. So what is the cash operating profit during the year is the term of interest in this first subcategory. Okay, let's go to the second category, which says cash flows from investing activities. Where does business invest the money? The business invests the money in the long-term assets. In the long-term assets of the business, what are these long-term assets? Well, you have land, you have office equipment, you have building, you have vehicle and whatnot. So the list can just go on. You can also have, you know, specifically the investment, the financial investment that you make. Let me write financial investment. And financial investments can further be into different instruments that are there, options that are there. So you could deposit it into the bank. You could purchase shares of another company. You could purchase debentures of another company. You could put your money in, other advanced financial instruments as well. Government bonds, for example, can also be a financial investment. So we're talking about purchase of assets, or we're talking about the financial investment, does not matter. But as long as you are putting money in an investment activity, we count that under this subcategory, cash flow from investing activities. Now, purchasing, this is the purchase, which means this will result in outflow. There will be inflows from investing activities as well. What are the inflows? The inflows are going to be when you sell these assets. It's possible that, you know, you have to sell the land or office equipment or building, vehicle. You do not start the business to buy and sell fixed assets, of course. But once in a while, whenever situation demands, you may want to sell these fixed assets. And not only fixed assets, these can be intangible intangibles as well. So fixed can have tangible or intangible assets. Also, investments could be sold as well. So sale of investment. And in addition to this, you could also have return coming in on the financial investments that you have. So if you have invested in deposits, you will get interest. So any interest money that you receive is a cash inflow due to investing activities of the business. So interest received, you can have dividend on the shares that you have purchased in another company, or again interest on the bonds, you can categorize that here. So the inflows do not only come from the sale of a given asset, but also the interest that you receive, the return that you make on those financial investments as well. This is the second category. Now let us go to the third category, which is called financing activities. What are the financing activities of the business? Financing means basically bringing in money to, you know, support your long-term growth in the business. How do you get that money? You get that money through loans, by issuing share capital, by issuing preference share capital. Okay. So when you issue share capital, let's say issue of share capital, issue of preference share capital, or you can say raising the loan from a bank. All of these things are going to bring money into the business. So money comes into the business due to sale of goods as well, and when you raise a loan as well. Both are sources of cash to the business, but when you raise a loan, it is a financing activity, not an operating activity. When you sell goods, it's an operating activity and not a financing activity. That is the kind of distinction we are trying to create here. So are there any other sources of long-term funds? We could mention them here. There can also be the outflows due to financing activities. Well, if you have raised loans, you'll have to pay interest on the loan. So any interest that is paid is going to be shown here. If you have issued shares to the people, to the investors, you'll have to pay dividend. Same for preference shares. You have to pay these people, you have to service the debt, you have to service the equity as well. And then you could repay the loans. So repayment or payment of the principal amount, the EMIs that you give, although EMI has both interest and the principal involved. So together you could call these EMIs. So repayment of loan. Equity capital is typically not redeemed. The preference capital can be redeemed. So redemption simply is a repayment. The word is used for preference share capital. So redemption of preference shares. Typically preference shares have a lifetime, 5 years, 10 years, and then you repay them. There you go. So financial activities, these are the activities which will be classified as financing activities. So you have a fair bit of idea about the operating activities of the business, investing activities of the business, and financing activities of the business. We are also going to do a tutorial where we look at a list of transactions and then we categorize it, and then we'll go on to looking at more details of the cash flow statement. I'll see you in the next video.